Hi guys, Shamdek here, and welcome to Tales from Candleforth. Where I play a little 2D spooky game. It's a point-and-click adventure game. But it's supposed to have spooky vibes, and I figure tis the season. So, distant voice. Is anyone there? Leave everything as it was, please. Someone hasn't cleaned here in a while. That's sticky. You should drop it. Oh, so right click to drop. That's a pumpkin-headed guy. Strange being. Hello there. So it was you, tiny creature, who was making all that noise. My name is Cal. It's a pleasure to meet you. Welcome to my dwelling. I have had a very long life, and I've gathered so many things from my adventures. Want to take a look? He does have a lot of stuff. What happened in the mirror? Oh, that? It broke coming back from a trip to Dangerous Mountain. It's funny to see your reflection cracked, don't you think? Like the cute little fire guys. I call her Mrs. Hoppy. She was wearing a ribbon when I bought her. Where could it be? Oh, please be careful with that. This is my favorite tea set, and it's so fragile. I love this little cups, like they were my children. Fragile and volatile creatures. Their life is so short. A frame would keep their beauty forever. Is that a self-portrait? That's an old portrait someone did of me long ago. Maybe he's dead and now the painting is worth millions. Who knows? Borrowed that from a couple of friends. They say if you wind the key while looking at the little mirror inside, you see people from other worlds. I traveled to a jungle and brought these back. What a nice silky touch. Do you think one of them will have twins? I don't know if I would want them to have. I'm just trying to make sure that I looked at everything before we go to the book, because I assume I have to click the book. He's very excited. I love this circus. It's been a long time since it's come to town. Hope they do soon so I can see them. I think we have clicked on everything I can click on, so now we'll go to the book. I got an achievement for that. Oh, did that caught your attention? That's the crown jewel, my favorite book. The phrasing threw me off a little bit. It's a compendium of tales about magic. I know how much you humans like that. This stuff. Magic makes you lose your minds. You know what? We could read one of these tales. The book makes the tales change every time someone different reads them, and I'm getting tired of reading the same tales. Sometimes I can't even meet my favorite characters. Now here comes the fun part. This magic book also have a different test for each person that tries to open it. Pick it up and see what it holds for you. Am I supposed to light up all of the... Nice. Let's see which story it's going to be this time. I'm gonna wait for it to fill in a little bit because I feel like I'm reading too fast. For a long time, the quiet village of Candleforth has been protected by the women of the Good family. Dorothy, her mother, and all that came before them have taken care of the village, making ointments and medicaments for the townsfolk. Dorothy has raised and protected her granddaughter Sarah since her mother passed away during childbirth. Now that Sarah is about to turn 15, it's time for her to accept her legacy and learn the secrets of the family trade. But suddenly, a mysterious and eerie affliction came over Dorothy. As her health fades away and her body grows weaker, the whole village is worried about her. One night, Dorothy wakes up, ready to make a difficult choice. But before that, she needs to leave something behind to ensure Sarah's well-being. Prologue, the last night. Dorothy, I trust you will make it. I love you. I need to put this in an envelope. I should leave. Where are you going? There's nothing interactable. I don't have time for this. That's the door. Okay. So I'm just gonna leave? On second thought, Sarah needs to know it was me who wrote this. Where did I leave the family seal? That's a good question. The stamp with the family crest. And to think we're the only ones left. A bit of warm wax. All set. The only thing left is to stamp it. It's getting late. I need to leave. No, it's too soon. I need to find a way out. What is that? Isn't there a window? It's been so long since the last time this happened. So that one looks like it needs water. Just have to move the clouds to protect them. I thought I was trying to water them or something. The fact that they kept changing back and forth. Oh, that poor baby. Oh. Don't be mean. Don't leave us hanging. I don't know who you are, sir. It's just a crack. Don't be such a crybaby is the achievement I just got. They found me. So I have to get 4 of them. Interesting. I have to stop this. I was not paying attention, I'll be honest. You got tired of playing, but we didn't. Sing out loud, it was music for my ears. I'm running out of time. Seems like I have to put the moth in for another one to appear. My little blue angel, I won't leave you here all alone. There we go, I got it. I will come back home, I promise. It's getting worse. How long can I keep running away from this thing? Get paper moths. The seams will eat me alive. Oh wow. I'm not looking so good. Leave this house alone. Finally, I made it. No, please, leave. Complete the last night. At sunrise, the house was cold and quiet as it has never been. Sarah went to check on her grandmother as usual, but to her surprise, she wasn't in her bedchamber. So Sarah ran down the creaking stairs to the apothecary thinking she might be there. When she arrived, she found the door cracked open and its key laying on the ground. It was strange. Her grandmother always kept that door shut tight. Oh, the violin. Sarah decided to enter and discovered the entire room unorganized with no sign of Dorothy anywhere. Even her old violin was now wrecked. She came closer to Dorothy's desk where she spent most of her days finding a closed leather. Chapter 1, The Apothecary. That's our family sigil. And now we're Sarah. This letter must be from Grandma. I have to read it. Maybe it says something about where she went. My dearest Sarah, I'm so sorry for leaving you like this. Much has happened in recent weeks that I wish to shield you from, but it has overtaken our lives and I had to go away. To make a brew that cures this illness, I need you to bring 3 ingredients. A black witch's seed, some Melita's nectar, and a branch from a dryad tree. Take this as the final milestone of your magic training. I left you an elixir to help you in this task. I trust you will make it. I love you. The final test to get my magic powers at last. But how is Grandma in danger? She's the strongest person I know, and all the people in Candleforth love her. Never mind, I must help her. Okay, so the letter says I have to find an elixir to help me get the 3 ingredients. Click on anything. He wants me to find the elixir right away. I want to click on everything. It is by the mirror. This has to be the elixir Grandma mentioned. The label says drink me. I'm sure this will help me get through this. I don't know if that was a good idea. You shouldn't just drink random things you don't know about. I feel somehow different. I've torn off a piece of the wall. It looks like there's something inside, but I can't see it properly. Is this part of the final test? I'm going to look for the ingredients around here. That's an interesting mark. I thought maybe I could click on the birds or something. Oh, so this must be missing books. Lots of puzzles. That's the flower one. That looks like the one thing that I need. Books that I put in that bookshelf. I saw it coming from afar, but right before, smelling its putrid aura, I heard the ground creak behind me. It touched my hair, and a taste of blood flooded my mouth. Dorothy. Oh, is that the note that I just read? Saw, smell, heard, touched. smell coming from afar. So it's all her smell. All her smell touched. I don't know what that did, but that's correct, I'm guessing. I need one more book, it looks like. Oh, the birds is where you want that. Birds moving also had something to do with it, so what'd I get? Strange bottle, are those bugs? I also have pins. Pruning. Alright, so let's go back here. Those two are set. I'm assuming that's the cauldron, so I just have to figure out the bugs. I gotta do something to get that open. Found the book. I Don't know what I'm supposed to do with that, but I have it, I guess. Oh, that's for that other box. Or not the box, the wall. So the clock is worn. This way? No, I think it's the other. Alright, so as I solve puzzles, it opens up more. This thing, the shelf. I'm assuming this is one. So then it's the triangle, the arrow, the U. I mean, I feel like I would need the needle for this, but... Well, we got the last book, so I guess see if I can figure that out. But then that doesn't work because I don't have another one on this side. Thank you. I feel like I'm close. It just makes me wonder if I'm missing a book. Maybe there's supposed to be an... Now I should double because I have the little sleep. I feel like the butterfly's gonna go in the middle. Working a little bit backwards. I don't know what puzzle those symbols are for, but we now have them. can't leave yet. Don't that make sense? I genuinely don't remember seeing anything with those symbols is the problem. This looks like a box, so I was trying to click on the table for that, but it just takes me back. I'm thinking there's got to be something with this and the pin, so I don't know what else we can put the pin on. this is. No. I am setting the stage. What? I am a horrible stagehand. Well, that's not very good. Grand finale, what a beautiful scene. What have I done? Oh, this is broken now. A chrysalis? Of course, this must be the black witch seed, the first ingredient. Oh, here's the symbols for the... the books. So we'll do a couple at a time. So I have like a crown and an H. I think that's the H looking. Alright, let's see if it's faster to go this way. Yep. Have like mustache or arms. A sideways hourglass. And then the S. Well, that's not very nice. So I'm assuming the moth symbol is that for this box. I have to think about where to find the other two ingredients. Grandma taught me. I accidentally clicked before I finished that. Barn key? If I go there, maybe I could find something around the fields. Alright, I guess we're going to the barn. Don't know what this is for still. Oh, this is broken. The apothecary. Complete the apothecary. Oh, I finished. Well, the first chapter. Sarah ran out of the house holding the letter on her hand and making her way to the fields. Didn't it say in her hand? As she arrived, the triangular shape of the old barn emerged far away, darkened and withered by time. Meanwhile, the evening sky looms over Candleforth, plunging the peaceful town into the impending darkness that lurks at the beginning of the night. Chapter 2, The Fields. I'm assuming I have to pluck them off in some magical order. I'm so close. don't know how I figured that out, but we got there. Okay, so we need symbols for this. The door is closed. I should use the barn key. I thought it wouldn't have me go in and then unlock it. So this clearly has to do with this. Yeah. This is the regeneration circle. Grandma used it to change the condition of all types of things. It's so useful. So this is a sliding puzzle, but I don't know how, where anything needs to go. Oh, I see. There's one. I got a bone that looks kind of frail and a sun head. I wonder if these are trying to tell me something and I'm just not getting it. That looks like it goes there. So maybe it's the way I have to bonk them. Yeah. No, it's broken. There we go. Oh. I didn't need all that extra flare. It's a skull light, it has a dark aura. I thought maybe the pictures might have something to do with it. I'm guessing not. Oh, I can actually go other places. Those are some sad pumpkins. Oh, I see. So both hands up once the sun hits. The scarf is this one on the left. I don't think I have anything for the last one yet. Oh, there's the ribbon. That's probably what it was. Oh wait, scissors there. using all this magic circleness. Did I just get an eyeball? That was disgusting. Wait, these ribbons, I think I've seen them somewhere. There goes polka dots, stripes, diamonds, squiggles. I thought I had that in the right order, I'm gonna double check. Dots, stripes, diamonds, the squiggles. Oh, what is it? Because the flowers are facing the other way, so it's backward? It would be squiggle, diamond, stripe, polka dot. Yeah. As a pure aura. I don't know what that's about, but that's interesting. That's a lot of moss. And there's the barn. It's the hook, the L, and the person doing a weird dance. That's gross. So now we just need to go to the pumpkins, it looks like. I did that completely on accident. Oh no, there's more. How many times? I had it, and then I messed it up. Did I made it grow? What a strange pumpkin. And that's the little light that we need for in the silo. This is Melitta's nectar. I knew I'd find it here. Now I just need a branch from a dryad tree. I remember reading something about them. Not this again. I don't think we have a choice. Supposed to be giving them books. My bad. blessings, whatever they are. Oh. There's a fire. Sir, I need you to run away. Sir, there's a fire. I got complete the fields, and what a tragic end. Sarah came out of the seam, leaving behind an abyss with no form or fate, a void that devoured all light that crossed its path. After moments that seemed undying, Sarah started perceiving shapes around herself. She was surrounded by hundreds of ancient trees. She had left behind Candleforth sunset and surrendered to the faint light of the moon. Chapter 3, The Forest. You shouldn't be in the forest in the night. These woods, I don't like being here alone. I've come here with my grandma, but at night everything looks different. Well, yeah, it's dark and spooky. I still have to find the third ingredient. Could I get it here? I assume so. That's a mirror that's missing pieces. Well, that's an interesting game. I just get a jar of eyeballs. Creepy bait. I could fish for something. What a silly little girl, lost in the forest. She went so many times. Dread. Or. Dread. Or. Or. Panic. Panic. Fear. Right. Alright, it's just being mean. Oh. All right, so it's the right one, the left one. One. Right. Left. Second. I'll figure it out at some point. So it's right, left, second, third. Process of elimination. Is that a tree? So creepy. Okay, it just stays like that. I don't have to do it again, thankfully. It says the same thing. Who said that? It was me? Nobody loves you, and that's why you are alone. Your mother got rid of you, and now your grandmother, too. That's not true. Mom, she loved me, and Grandma too. I just need to find her. And what are you supposed to be? A witch without power? You are useless. Making her emotions. Grandma has been teaching me all these years. Look how far I got without her help. Without her help, you say? She was leaving clues for you, and still you're not capable of finding her. I hit too fast. Please leave me alone. You don't know anything about me. How naive. And you think you know something? Take this. Let's see if you're ready to know the truth. Seen a spot where it would fit. didn't know that was a thing. Well, that was weird. Didn't realize I could look up. Oh, it fit there. So an H, arrow, an X. We have the H, the arrow. It's probably because I didn't do them in order. A W. A ram. I don't know what that is. Person holding something, another person holding something. That was a guess. I had no idea. That's interesting. It makes me... There's a little symbol, though. Wonder if it's, like, telling that the rejuvenation scroll was used on... Circle was used on me. Or her mom. I just realized that that's faces. Oh. Thank you. So that one looks right. I don't know about the other one. There we go. I have a fish with two tails, a leech looking thing, and a root looking thing. What could this mean? I should think about it. I'm assuming it has something to do with the fish. Okay. Well, this is interesting. That's clearly where I go fishing. So the dolls are gonna have to go in the correct order, it's just a matter. I was trying to pair them up, but there's an oddball. I was thinking this half matches this half and matches this. These two. But then you got this amalgamesh. I'm just thinking. I'm just staring, thinking. Because of the odd number and the odd man out, something's gotta. There's gotta be one that's a starting point. Oh, what a pretty doll. Can I take it home? I think the answer to that question is no. Oh, it fell inside. Maybe it's better that way. Still need a hook of some. Need that, please. interesting. I didn't realize I could interact with the mirror, so I'm wondering if I put the eyeballs. Wait. I see 5 marks behind this one. 7. Looks like 6. So 5, 7, 6. Interesting dilemmas. Yeah, because that's the same fish I caught. All right, back to the fish. There it is. Oh, I have to move them. I didn't realize I can move the fish. All right, let's see how good my memory is. So it's 2 above, 3 below, 2 above, 4 below, 4 and 5. A pocket watch. I'm assuming that's what I give the other mirror self. There we go. That doesn't look so good. Sir, I have nothing left. I'm just double checking. I'm not seeing anything else. I'm not too sure, but I feel like since I completed the mirror, something should have happened. I just didn't click in the right spot, I guess. An oak's branch. It said they share their lives with the dryads. This has to be the last ingredient. Oh, that doesn't look good. Okay, let's go one more time. Oh, it's Dorothy. Sarah, why are you still here? You must keep your distance with the seams. They're not safe. Grandma, you're here. I didn't know what to do. These things, it's like they almost draw me in. But it's okay now. I have all three ingredients. You will get better. Oh, I'm so sorry you went through all that, but you did great, my dear. Please, take this and get back to the barn. You'll know what to do, and don't worry about this seam. I'll close it myself. See you soon. Leave this to me. Trust your elders. The forest. Complete the forest. The two achievements I got. After the brief encounter with her grandmother, the seam closed with her on the other side. Sarah was sobbing unconsolably, but as she was trying to calm herself down, something happened. Out of the blue, the paper moth Dorothy gave her started gleaming with a blinding light and pointed the path to follow out of the forest. Chapter 4, Night at the Barn. It's so dark, I don't like it. At least Grandma's moth is still glowing. The barn chain. Should I take a look inside? And there went my moth. Oh, wow. Grandma, what has happened to you? I didn't want you to see me like this. I almost have no energy left. I'm glad you got here in time. Can I see the ingredients? Oh, you really got everything. Thank you so much, dear. Now I will get better. But there's still something left to get your powers. Take these ingredients and put them where they belong, please. I know you can do it. I'll wait for you right here. What was that? A giant moth and it's bleeding. Grandma, I think I made it. Oh, you really did it. I'm so proud of you. Now come closer, dear. You are ready. Take my hand so my powers can pass into your body. Well, this is weird. I remember there being a heart above. scissors. I'm gonna have to go back and look at a face. So we have a heart, a face. Oh, it's a key. So a heart, a key, scissors, book. Scissors. Find the key again. Here's a solid. So going bottom up, I have a C, a Y, a T, something, a W, A, and then something. So Oh, I'm with them. And what's on her side, though? Okay, so it's the XA circle. Arrow. That's correct. The arrow, the X, the A, the circle. Now it's E, 4, arrow, triangle. I know we were playing matching. Not you, not anymore, sacrifice, and night at the barn, complete night at the barn. Those are the two achievements I just got. I'm sorry, my dear, I didn't have a choice. You're my only next of kin left. This is my gift and my curse. It was a necessary sacrifice. Candleforth needs me, and that body couldn't endure any longer. So mom left because your mother was very clever, almost as clever as you. She discovered everything and ended her life, putting in danger. Now everything's how it's supposed to be. Thank you, my child. I couldn't have done this without you. So you passed on your curse to me? Now the only thing left. Here you are. It's Cal. Oh, what are we going to do with you? Betrayal. Tales from Candleforth, developed by Under the Bed. I don't know why the text got so fast at the end, but I guess the gist of it is that the grandma had a curse from I'm guessing some deal she made with Cal. And now it passed on to me, and we just helped him find her. And our mom decided to take a different way out of the situation. I don't know if there's going to be anything after the credits, so I'm just going to let them play and then just talk through them in case, you know. You never know with music and games anymore. I've never seen a funded by Sarah in credits before, unless I've just never paid attention. I don't know what WYs is or if it's something else. Made in Unity, that makes sense. Was good for a point and click puzzle game. I feel like they could have given you a little bit more direction on a couple of puzzles, but overall it was good. Cute little thanks for playing screen. Well, that is it. My plan was just to stream this in its entirety, then end the stream. So, this is our first game for spooky season this year. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for stopping by the stream. I hope you have a good rest of your day, night, evening, or whatever time it is for you, and hope to see you next time.